It took 6 trips to move most of Tyler Sproston's belongings from Richmond to his new home in Gladstone. 6 trips, because he had to move everything in his personal car instead of the truck he'd reserved at U-Haul.
I've spoken to 8 people, wasted an obscene amount of time, and have no idea why I couldn't rent from their company.
Tyler says the problem started September 5th. That was moving day. He was unaware of any problem with his reservation until he tried to do the mobile check-in. It wouldn't accept his driver's license.
No reason. They couldn't verify my identity.
He called U-Haul. A customer service agent suggested he go to the store in person and see if that would resolve the problem.
We go through the entire process. I have the truck reserved. I give him my driver's license, run my debit card, and then the gal who was helping me, she's like, oh, we have an e-alert.
Tyler was handed this piece of paper and told to call corporate. He did, and that's when he really got frustrated.
And then she gives me another gentleman's number. So I call him, and he's like, I have no idea what's going on.
He's then sent to someone else.
I go through the entire story again.
That person at corporate calls the local store in Liberty.
She gets back on the phone, and she says, they said something was off. I said, what was off? I said, I walked in there with a valid driver's license, a valid debit card. I have a perfect driving record. You know, I paid for their insurance. Why am I unable to rent a truck with your company? And she says, well, they have the right to refuse service.
Tyler was livid, which is why he called Fox 4 Problem Solvers. His request
Good
was
girl.
Simple.
I want to know why.
Because there's nothing wrong with his credit or his driving record, he wondered whether U-Haul denied him because he's transgender, although he's rented from U-Haul before as a transgender man.
That's the only thing I can think of. And I'm 39 years old. I have never in my life said, I've never been treated that way, first of all. I'm not going to brag, most people love me.
Anytime someone goes through transition and transitions to living, either as to the sex other than what they were assigned at birth, it becomes an issue when you don't have consistent documentation.
Attorney Madeline Johnson helps transgender clients maneuver through the maze of legal documents that need to be changed to reflect a new gender. Although Tyler had his name legally changed after transitioning 13 years ago, he's never changed his gender on his driver's license, something he thought he couldn't legally do. So that's why Tyler's photo doesn't match his gender designation, which is still listed as female. U-Haul said Tyler's gender wasn't the problem. The problem was that when Tyler presented his driver's license to U-Haul, the gender was blacked out. When an official document appears altered, it brings the entire document into question. Well, here's the good news. Tyler shouldn't need to worry about this again. Missouri law allows transgender people to change their driver's license gender by simply providing a doctor's note or a note from a therapist. Tyler said he plans to apply for a new license right away.
Tyler says he wishes U-Haul had just told him that was the problem instead of leaving him to wonder. He said if they had done that, he would have never called us. Fox 4 Problem Solver, Linda Wager, working for you.